The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confuses me. Clouds as mean as you've ever seen. And a bird who knows your tune. Then a little voice inside you whispers.
Hey, it's Mike Rhyner of Sports Radio 1310 The Ticket. You're watching Elk TV, man.
What we do here is go back.
Hello, Elk Nation. I'm Hailey Smith.
And I'm Gracie Flanigan. And you're watching Elk News.
We are your guest news anchors for this week, and we wanted to prepare you for an upcoming segment entitled Sign,
in which ASL students, including us, teach you a term or phrase in ASL.
In the news this week, a devastating series of tornadoes ripped through Alabama on Sunday, killing at least 23 people in one county.
The victims, including children, died in Lee County, says Sheriff Jay Jones. Jones described massive damage that appeared as if someone had been taken a blade and just scraped the ground. He estimated a path of destruction about a half a mile wide that stretched several miles to the east from where the tornado touched down.
An Oregon man and his dog were found alive Friday, 5 days after their vehicle got stuck in snow, forcing the 36-year-old to eat packets of Taco Bell hot sauce to survive.
Jeremy Taylor and his dog, Allie, were found just after 2 p.m. Friday, after he was reported missing on Wednesday, 5 days after their vehicle got stuck in the snow.
Boy, talk about a survival story.
In campus news, you may be aware that the flu is spreading throughout our community and our schools are being impacted as well. The district has seen an increase in absences because of the flu.
Common symptoms of the flu include high fever, severe headaches, muscle and body aches, exhaustion, and dry cough.
If you're sick, stay home. Seriously. Yeah, school's important, but if you get me sick, I will hunt you down.
Okay. Easy.
I'm good. Thanks. Here's some other important information.
And that's the news for this week, Elk Nation. I'm Hailey Smith.
And I'm Gracie Flanigan, and you're watching Elk News.
All right, stop what you're doing.
Hey, everybody, this is Donovan Lewis from The Ticket, and you are watching Elk TV.
But yo, I'm making money, see, so yo.
Hello, Elk Nation. I'm Caden Wells, but you can call me Chuck. And I'm Andrew Roy, and you're watching Elk Sports.
Well, Andrew, it was a great week in sports for Burleson High School, as we had four sporting events Tuesday and we won all four.
That's right, Caden. Our men's soccer team played at home against Everman Tuesday, and they won 1-0 off a goal by senior Henry Garcia, sophomore Kaylor
Yogurt
had the assist, and junior goaltender Gabriel Bustillos pitched the shutout.
The women also played Everman and overpowered the Bulldogs 6-0. Jordan Walker, Adriana Zaragoza, Macy Massengill, and Emily Marks each pitched in a goal, while sophomore Savannah Riggs netted two. And phenom freshman goaltender Faith Gilstrap shut the door on the Lady Elks' goal for that night.
The BHS varsity softball team won Tuesday's away conference game against Mansfield Timberview by a score of 15-3.
Wait, say that again?
15-3, yo.
Please don't say yo.
There were too many people scoring runs to talk about here, so instead, Kate and I are going to look at each other awkwardly while we freeze frame and scroll the stats on the screen between us.
Nice. You look good in freeze frame.
Thanks. Meanwhile, the Burleson varsity baseball team won Tuesday's home non-conference game against Springtown by a score of 4-2. Heading into the game, Springtown averaged almost 3 runs per game, more than the Elks for the season, but our pitching held them nearly 5 runs below their season average. Caden, want to do another freeze frame of stats?
Duh, who wouldn't?
Well, we have 4 more contests scheduled for today. The varsity softball team has an away conference game at Arlington Seguin at 6 p.m. Varsity baseball is at Brewer at 1:20 p.m. And varsity soccer is playing in Crowley at 6 p.m. for the boys and 8 p.m. for the girls.
So obviously you can't get to all those games, right? So here's my solution for you. Go check out the soccer teams tonight in Crowley.
Why is that? Why should they skip the baseball or softball games?
Well, for starters, the baseball game is during school, so our viewers can't skip class to go to that game.
Well, they could, but not legally, so why soccer instead of softball?
First, soccer is in Crowley, which is closer than Arlington Seguin, where softball is playing. Also, if you go to Crowley, you get to watch 2 of our teams play, instead of just 1. And finally, the soccer field in Crowley is very nice, and it is named after Gary Reasons, who is the only Crowley high school football player to ever play in the National Football League.
I am simultaneously amazed by your logic and troubled that you know that level of history of Crowley High School football.
It's a gift. It's a gift. Now on to pro sports. The NFL hosted its scouting combine this week. The NFL scouting combine is a vital event in the path to the draft. More than 300 prospects will participate in the 2019 combine in their quest to achieve their NFL dreams.
That's right, Caden. And at the combine, Cowboys owner Jerry Jones tried to pretend like he wants to win more than he wants to make money and be respected, but you know. Anyway, the Cowboys will screw up the draft and get roasted in the first round of the playoffs anyway.
In the NBA, after trading away 4 of their 5 starters recently, the Dallas Mavericks are well on their way to taking this season away, having lost 2 games this week by a combined total of 69 points. If they can suck bad enough, they'll be able to get high draft pick and some actual talent around Luka and Unicorn next season. So tank away, Mavericks. Tank away.
The Texas Rangers. Ha, never mind. You know the deal. They don't have a single player ranked in the top 100 in the major leagues, so gear up for a season of suck, Rangers fans.
Well, the Stars had a good week, accumulating wins in 4 of 5 road games in those games. Captain Jamie Benn scored a hat trick against St. Louis, and goaltender Ben Bishop pitched a shutout against the New York Rangers.
At least we have the Stars to keep our hopes up.
Well, that's sports for this week, Elk Nation. I'm Chuck Wells with Caden Wells.
And I'm Andrew Roy, and you're watching Elk Sports.
Hi, my name is Sean Bass from Sports Radio 1310 and 96.7 FM The Ticket. You are watching Elk TV.
Bass.
Sometimes there's a sound.
Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
A sound that just eats through your soul.
We take back all three chambers of Congress.
The most annoying sound in the world.
And have no clue what I'm talking about.
Today, we will find that sound.
It's the Rise of the Pope.
Can you make an annoying sound? Can you make the most annoying sound in the world?
Hello, Burleson High School!
Is that good enough?
Can you make the most annoying sound in the world? Can you make the most annoying sound in the world?
Hi, I'm Bob.
And I'm Dan.
You are watching Elk TV right now.
Yeah, you're watching.
I'm in love with Dan McDowell.
Hello, Elk Nation. My name is Evelyn, and you're watching Elk TV. Today, we're going to look at the top five vines of all time. Number five made our list because if you say Mother Trucker Dude, literally every person in the room will finish quoting the vine.
Mother Trucker Dude! That hurt like a butt cheek on a stick.
Number four made our list because it had a perfect blend of that was a real candid shot and obviously that kid staged that.
I have the power of God and anime on my side!
I'm not sure if number three really needs an explanation. It's just the thing of beauty.
Country boy, I love you.
Our number two comes from a kid that had three different vines in the top 100.
Chris, is that a weed?
No, this is a crayon.
I'm calling the police!
911, what's your emergency?
And let me see what you have!
Annoying!
No!
Oh my God, oh my God.
Happy birthday, Raven!
I can see.
I smell like beef. I smell like beef.
Help me first!
I'll save you!
Woohoo! He's already gone!
Yeah, but that backflip though.
Look at all those chickens!
Road work ahead? Yeah, I sure hope it does.
Number one is the most copied vine on the list. Here are a few copycat versions.
What are those?
Any questions?
I got one question for you. What are those?
What would you like to know?
What are those?
Excuse me, sir.
I got one question for you. What are those? It's SpongeBob. I got one question for you. What are those?
And here's the original, our number one.
Officer, I got one question for you. What are those?
This is Jake Kemp with The Ticket, and you are watching Elk TV, a program produced by students who will one day take my job.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jake Kemp.
Flashback begins.
Zoom in or out?
Start.
No, he's already had his eyes.
Zoom out as he talks about the dentistry question. After it shows people walking in, it gives detail of their backstory. Introduce.
Is like the therapy scene from The Great Gatsby?
It's the Breakfast Club.
It's the Breakfast Club.
After everyone is introduced, someone will die. What the actual heck? I can't say the actual word. People get into groups and split up to try and find out what happens to the person who died. While split up, people.